Hello and welcome back to Coding with T. In today's tutorial, we're going to learn how to design the banners screen inside our Flutter e-commerce admin panel. So first of all, let's quickly see what we are going to achieve. Okay, our application is running and let's scroll a bit down to the banners over here. So this is what we are going to create. We have already completed design for brands and categories. And in the next tutorial, we're going to design the products, which is going to be very informative video because the product screen is a bit tricky. So over here, we have the banners. We can see the image. Then the redirect screen, this is going to redirect to the search screen. Then these two banners, three banners are active. That's why we can see this eye. But when they are not going to active, we will not see this icon. Then we have edit and action option. So whenever this banner is going to be selected, inside the app, we are going to redirect to the specific screen, which is the manual way. And you are going to create the banner. This is what you will see. We have an option to select the image. Then we can make this banner active or inactive. Then this is the list from where we can choose the option. We can redirect to the cart screen, to the checkout, order, product review, product search, setting screens in the app. So whenever the user is going to select this banner, user can reach to the order page, the brands, user profile, user address. Let's say we want to let the user go to the brands. There is another way to do this redirection, which is using the deep links inside the Flutter app, because at this stage deep links are going to be overburdened. So that's why I decided to go with the static option. So by this way, we are going to select any of the screen in which we want to let the user sign in, sign up, or where, whatever screen we want to redirect the user to. And inside that, we have already implemented this feature. So whenever we are going to add this option from here, and when we're going to create this, so let's select the image, and from the gallery folder or the media folder, we have to select the banners. And over here we have a bunch of images. Let's select this one or this one. Click on add, and now you can see this image over here. You can change the image, click on add again, and the image is now changed. So this is how we can create the banners. We can also click on this icon to edit the banners, and again select on this image, select the banners folder, and I'm going to add this as the banner. Click on add, click on update, and it is going to process it, and you can see the record has been updated. Now click on the back arrow, and over here you can see this icon image has now changed. So this is what we are going to create in today's tutorial. So let's get started. So we are creating Flutter e-commerce admin panel, and inside we are going to create the second last section of our admin panel, in which we are going to design the screens. Once the design is completed, the last section is to add the backend functionality. We have already covered all the concepts, all the features that we need to create any type of admin panel using Flutter web. So make sure to watch those previous videos. You can also download the complete code. Link is in the description. And also you can get the e-commerce app code as well, which is link is in the description, and the playlist is already uploaded. I'll drop the link of that playlist also. So let's get started. Okay, we are inside our e-commerce admin panel, and in here we are going to go to the features, and in the shop, in the screens, we are going to create the banner screens. But first, as in the previous tutorials, we have to go to the routes. In the routes.dart, I have added the banners. You can call them routes, you can call them URLs. So these are the banner URLs which are going to be look like in the web browser URL. So if you are new again, you can watch the routing and navigation section of this playlist. Once these banners are created, head towards the app routes. Inside we have to declare all the three screens. The first one is to view all the banners, then create banner and edit banner screens using the same routes that we created, and this is the page or the widget that we want to display. So these screens I have created, so you just have to create these screens first. And again, before directly start coding, first of all, let's go to the common widgets, and in the layout sidebar, open the sidebar.dart. Next to the brands, we'll need to add the banners in the menu, and we are using the same T menu. Route is banners. This is the icon that we are using, and name is banners again. And after that, we are going to add the products. So once this is done, we have added the navigation. Now inside the screens, in the banners, we are going to use the same approach because we have three screens. So we have three folders over here, all with a small case and underscores without spacing. All banners, create and edit banners. So if we talk about the all banner first, we have again the main class banners.dart, which is using T-site template to view the desktop, tablet and mobile mode. So for each of the mod, we have different widgets. So we have banners desktop screen widget, banners tablet screen widget, and banners mobile screen widget, which is inside the responsive screens. So we have these three widgets, and the main table, which is going to be go inside all of these three screens, is over here. So we only have to create the table once, and we just add the layout inside the desktop, inside the banners, mobile, and tablet. And if you see the desktop, I have created the same exact layout as we done previously. Scaffold, single child scroll view, padding from the sides. Then in the column, we have breadcrumbs. This is the breadcrumbs design that we created in the previous tutorials. We created this widget and now we are using it. So this is the breadcrumbs widget, just a quick overview. And this is how it is going to look like. If you're new, you can watch the breadcrumbs video again. And in the T-rounded container, okay, then in the T-rounded container, which is the white space or the rounded white space with the shadow, and we have the first thing, which is table header that we created in the previous tutorials. Again, you can get the link in the description, T table header, and this is what we have. The first one is the button, a responsive button using expanded, and we are using the sizing depending upon the screens, its tablet, mobile, or desktop. And then the second one is the search text form field. Once this table header is created, we are going to jump towards the banners table, and same design is inside the mobile and inside tablet. Now if we talk about this banners table, so it's a banners tables class, which is a stateless widget, and we are using the TPaginatedDataTable, the one that we created. And again, you can get the link in the description. So it has minimum width, table height, and data row height. You can see the data row height is now increased as compared to previous two videos, in which we have only 60 as a height. Now we have 110 data row height because the banners image need a bit more space, so that's why we have the larger data row height. And then as a columns, we have the data column 2 and a text of banner, redirect screen, active, and actions. And you can see action has a fixed width of 100. So this is a property of data column 2. And then rows, for all the rows, we have the banners rows, which is a source. And you know that if you're already following, that for the rows, we need to use the data source or the data table source. And over here, we have the table source. This is the data table with the columns. This is a table source with the rows. And inside the rows, just to save the time, we are using the same T rounded image. First of all, to display our banner image. Currently, these are the static things. Instead of network, we need to use the asset image. Later on, we will change it. Then we have the redirect screen name. Currently, it's shop. Again, a static one. Then we have an icon over here if it is active or not. And then the third one is again two action options. The first one is to edit, and the second one is to delete this banner. And to edit this banner, we have get.toName because we want to redirect user to the edit screen. And this is the URL on which we want to edit. We would just have to pass the route name because it is toNamed. And as an argument, we are going to pass the banner model. Currently, it's an empty banner model, but later on, we will pass the banner model of this each row. And down below, we have 10 row counts and 0 row selected. These are the static values. So once this is done, nothing inside the widgets. So let's go to the Chrome and run this application. Okay, so we have the banners at the fourth position and or the fifth position. So let's click on the banners. And you can see, I think we do not have the image over here, but you can see we have the image. This is the size of the image. Then we have the redirect screen. This is the active status and action and delete button. When we're going to click on this action button, it's going to take us to this update banner because we do not have anything created. So, and also when we're going to click on this create banner, we will be redirected to the form. So this is the search. Now let's test it to the tablet mode, reduce the size. So this is the tablet mode. And now let's reduce it further to reach to the mobile device. And you can see redirect screen, active, and action buttons are coming closer. So let's go further. This is the mobile size, and we can scroll them. Down below, we have the option to scroll it again in the horizontal direction, and we can see all the data. Down below, we have options to go with the pagination, etc. So this is what we wanted to create. Let's create the create new banner and the edit banner form. So for that, let's close all banners, go to create banner, and again we have the same create banner with desktop, tablet, and mobile designs. In the responsive screen, we have these three options. And as while talking about the responsiveness, if you do not want to create the different layouts for different screens and you want to stick with the same design and you do not want to change anything in the layouts, you can simply use this one thing and you can remove these two things, and automatically this will be applied for tablet and desktop mode by this widget. So like this, you just have to pass the one option for the desktop, and that will apply using this widget by the desktop layout to desktop, tablet and mobile. You can see we are passing the layout desktop, and if there is tablet, otherwise desktop, if there's mobile, otherwise desktop. So you can choose to provide or not provide, but the desktop is required, and the same design will be applied for other screens. And in that case, you also do not need to use these two screens as well, but just for the efficiency or to let you know that you can create different type of layouts, I'm going to stick with these options. So let's create the desktop layout as previously created: a scaffold, single child scroll view, padding from all the sides. In the column, we have the breadcrumbs over here, the breadcrumbs with a back arrow enabled so that it can reach to the previous screen. Heading is create banner, breadcrumb items as TRoutes. Not categories, because I copied them, TRoutes.banners, and then create banner. And the same is for the mobile and tablet. And then over here we have a widget which is create banner form. Okay, inside the create banner, I have added all the form just to save the time, and I can go through all these steps one by one and you can create it. So we have the T-rounded container first of all with a width of 500, and then we have the padding around the form. Then we have a form widget, and in the form, first of all, we have the text or the heading with the spacing at top and bottom. Then we have a column to upload the image, which is using the T rounded image, and we have width, height, background, image is default image, and image type is asset. So whenever we are going to select the image, we will display selected image with the network type over here. Then we have a text button, which is going to be select, or whenever it is going to be triggered to open the media screen or the media pop-up in which we are going to select the image to be displayed over here for the banners. And then we have a text for the checkbox, make sure banner active or inactive. Then we have a checkbox menu, static values, then spacing, and then we have a drop down menu for different type of screens. So it is currently showing all the static values. Press Ctrl Alt L. So first of all, the default value is search, on change is empty, items, static items, two items. And then we have a button with a create option to create the button. So that's it for the design. And we are going to use the same design, which is over here. Copy this, go to edit banner in the widgets. Instead of edit brand form, rather copy this one and open this. And we are going to paste it over here. So again, I am just going to copy the T-rounded container so that we do not need to change the names over here. Instead of create new banner, we are going to call it update banner. And instead of create button, we are going to call it update. And you can see we are receiving the banner over here in the edit form widget, which we are going to send later on so that we can display the already selected banner as selected inside this form. And we will assign this form with the new data of banner. So that will be inside the backend tutorial. So for now, this one is created. The edit banner is same like the create banner. So let's run this application, and also let me show you this edit banner. Over here, we are going to receive the banner that we are passing from this table. If you see the table source, we are calling the edit screen along with the arguments. We are passing the complete banner model. So if you go to the edit banner, over here we are receiving the arguments, because there's only one thing receiving. So that is banners, and we're passing the same banner to desktop, tablet and mobile. And inside these screens, the same banner is being passed to the edit banner screen. Instead of doing this approach, you can directly cut it from here and go to the edit banner form, and you can even call the same thing over here to receive the banners. Okay, so let's save it. Let's click on create new banner, and you can see we have a form with the image. Then we can have a button to select the image. We will display a media pop-up, then a checkbox, currently static, and then we have a drop down to select home and search. So after that, we have a create button, and if we go back and click on edit button, you can see we have again update banner form. So this is how we are going to deal with the banners. And by this way, that's it for today's tutorial. I hope you learned something new, and if you have any questions, you can ask me down below in the comments. Once again, thank you for watching. And if you want to download the complete code, link is in the description for both app and admin panel. Thank you for watching and take care.